Hey, how can I have a podcast just like Joe Rogan's? Hey, I'm Dave Jackson from the schoolofpodcasting.com answering that question. How do I get a podcast just like Joe Rogan? Well, I want to give you a little behind the scenes. Joe started his career in 1988. That's 1988 in Boston. He moved to LA 6 years later, and he actually starred in some TV shows. He starred in Hardball. He starred in News Radio. I think that's the first time I saw him. But realize that's 6 years after he started. In 1997, he got involved with the Ultimate Fighting Championship as a color commentator. That's 9 years after he started. In 2000, so that is 12 years after he started his comedy career, he released his first comedy special. 12 years. In 2001, he started hosting Fear Factor. Actually put his comedy on hold for that because he was on NBC. That's pretty cool. Now, in 2003, he took over for Adam Carolla and Jimmy Kimmel. He was one of the co-hosts of The Man Show on Comedy Central. He did that for 2 years. Also in 2003, he was involved with Last Comic Standing, another mainstream TV show, as a talent scout. Now, in 2006, Fear Factor went away, and he went back to comedy. And 3 years later, in 2009, so he started in 1988, 2009, he launches his podcast. And according to Wikipedia, take that for what it's worth, he's getting, in 2015, 16 million downloads a month. And you're like, wow, I want to do that. And one of the things I want to point out about Joe is watch him do an interview. He is completely focused on his guest, absolutely just locked in. And you think, wow, 16 million downloads, that would be awesome. Realize the good people, the really talented people, make it look so easy. I'm a guitar player, and I saw a video once of Stevie Ray Vaughan, and he unstraps his guitar, whips it behind his back, and then straps it back on and keeps on playing. And I'm here to tell you, I've tried that over and over and over. I can never make it look as easy as Stevie does. And Joe does this as well. The super talented people, whoever she or he is, they make it look easy. So here's the thing I need to let you know. I just gave you Joe's resume, and here's the thing. You can't get to Joe's status unless you start back again. Think 1988. Well, just realize if you start today, then years from now, people may be looking and listening to your podcast going, they just make it seem so easy because you've done the work. And the best time to start that work is right now and start building your resume, start building your influence, start building your community, start building your tribe if we're going to use those buzzwords and get your podcast going. And I would love to help you with that. That's how you make a podcast like Joe Rogan, and he just makes it look so easy.